Hello everyone, my name is Mythrell and welcome to Quantum Break. So we are continuing with the boss fight today. So this is day 2. I'm doing these videos because yesterday I just completely got too mad at the game and didn't finish it. So maybe today I have a fresh eyes and maybe we'll be more successful. I did some reading on the internet that some people also had some issues with the mission, so it's definitely not just me. But. From what I understand, I got pretty close last time. Basically, all I needed to do was to kill that big guy and then avoid some stuff, but of course I never did. Oh, so let's get into the mood.
Better not, Jack.
Okay, and I failed. So, the main thing is try to avoid the ball skill, but yeah, I just showed how not to do it. Yeah. I keep accidentally pressing the shift button to run sometimes, and that just completely locks out the time shift skill. And
better not, Jack.
I never remember to use the time dodge itself, so. So maybe I won't this time. Jesus. Actually, a little bit too close. No, it's actually worked better than I hoped. And then the phase 2. It's actually pretty intense. Jesus. Point number one would be don't get stuck on into the environment. Okay, I don't think this weapon actually has range. Probably out of range as well. Oh, fucking! I didn't realize that. This is. I have to say that this is one of the. Well, I'm not gonna say stupidest, but it's kind of weird, to be honest. Okay, let's take the shotgun first.
Better not, Jack.
Every time you see the red thing while doing, basically what you should do is just to get the hell out of there. Just always doesn't work quite that way. Come on! Stop! I suppose I didn't die. I accidentally climbed on that goddamn thing.
Gotta move.
We're dead. Yeah, the walls doesn't actually do anything. I just hide there to try to survive that, but yeah, the walls don't actually help you at all. That was one of my mistakes. But the mistake on that one was that my running ability was locked when the wall activated, I suppose.
Better not.
Just terrible ending to a game. I mean, this game wasn't really that hard. So why the heck would you make the last mission to be this ridiculously harder than the game itself? I mean, sure, it's nice to extend the game by some artificial thing, but still, I don't just agree with this. This weapon probably doesn't have a range. Run! Okay, he's dead. Come on, camera!
Yeah.
For a moment I thought I was just low HP. But that explosion was actually coming towards me. I just feel like this is such a cheap last fight. I guess that the dodge button is the same than the running button. Kinda. Jeez. Okay, hold down. That's probably last of those. Oh no. I mean the smaller guys. Oh. And I somehow had to kill this guy. Where the hell did the big guy go? Why the fuck the camera angle change? That is bullshit. I'm dead. Holy shit. Now he changes, right? I don't actually know what is going to happen. Oh shit, he died? So let me guess, none of those choices I actually made mattered one single bit on the story. I'm pretty sure he will rise up.
What do you need?
The countermeasure's charge is low. We'll need a jolt of chronon particles. A jump start. That's you.
Yep. And Time Bandit. And Time Cop. Okay, so the game is now complete.
Countermeasure. It stitched time back together everywhere.
Cool.
The destruction couldn't be undone. The lives we lost were real. But we fixed it.
Jack. Will.
Clocks kept on ticking.
Come on. Come on.
I think we just saved the universe.
Yeah. Where's Paul?
He's dead. He's gone. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Will, he was wrong about everything.
Was he?
Will. The countermeasure worked.
Whoa. Countermeasure burned out. Should be stable now. Of course, I'll have to run a few tests to confirm. But this... Well, there's no reason to believe that the fracture isn't over.
So Jack's been bullied through the time. Or something.
One more question. Paul Serene's entire philosophy was that time is a set path, and nothing can be changed. At the time, you obviously disagreed. But after everything you've seen and done, we need to know. What do you believe now?
Right, I totally forgot it was Alo interview.
Was he right? Or is it possible to change things?
I'll come back for you.
Oh. Okay, yeah. So, my closing opinion on the game. I mean, it's a good game, there's no denying that. The story is great. The TV series is great. Although it looks a little bit low budget to my eye, at least. I think the TV series could work as a alone series as well. Because the story is just so great. And I don't actually think they needed to make this a game at all. The game accomplished pretty much nothing. It was just pretty much standard console shooter. I would call it cover shooter, but they actively tried to encourage you to stay out of cover, even though the cover was a mechanism in the game. But in the end, it's just the gameplay itself, it's just disappointing, to be honest. And it's just not just because I'm bad at it, but it's pretty much the same as you would say something like Max Payne 2 15 years ago. Or something like that. Maybe 10 years is closer. But anyway. New abilities, yeah, sure. Change abilities, yeah, sure. But nothing too great. But maybe the game console gameplay has become that. It's just maybe people like playing the standard game every time. But in any case, the combat system is not bad. It's just mediocre, is my opinion. It's. I don't want to be overly critical, but overall the game received okay reviews. I mean, good reviews, but not the greatest reviews. And I have to agree with that. It is as a game, it's good. But as a story, I really, really liked it. So as a story, it was a great story. As a TV series, it might have been great. But as a game, it's mediocre. Or not mediocre, but good, still good. But yeah. So, I think that's the closing thought on this game. I will try to avoid this time cross games in future because I generally don't like console, so-called console games. And I don't mean that they are in console so they are bad. I mean that the game style used for console is bad in my opinion. I'm not a fan of the console type of games, which this is pretty much exactly. So, because I don't want to play games that I don't want to play. Simple as that, but yeah. I hope to see you on the next episodes. Anything, if anyone watches this, the views on Quantum Break has been very low. And it's not a surprise I came too late to this game. It has been out for a few months already. But nevertheless, I did enjoy the game and I will remember it fondly, but sadly, a little bit disappointed. But yep, I'm gonna leave you to the end text, and maybe there's something after this, I don't know. Maybe I wanna see other clips, maybe there is a video after this, but yep. See you on the next episode. I've been sitting in my basement patio. Up above, girls walk past, their roses all in bloom. Have you ever heard about the Higgs boson blues? I'm going down to Geneva, baby, gonna teach it to you. Drove and drove, I came upon
chumps with a $10 guitar strapped to his back looking for a tune. Well, here comes Lucifer with his canon law and a 100 black babies running from his genocidal jaw. He got the real killer groove, Robert Johnson and the Devil Man. Dunno who's gonna rip off who. Driving my car, flame trees on fire, sitting and singing the Higgs boson blues. I'm tired, I'm looking for a spot to drop. All the clocks have stopped in Memphis now. In the Lorraine Motel, it's hot, that's why they call it the hot spot. I take a room with a view, hear a man preaching in a language that's completely new. Spiritual groove, everybody bleeding to the head pulse and blues. And if I die tonight, bury me in my favorite yellow patent leather shoes. I'm with a mummified cat. And moves on to Amazonia, cries with the dolphins. The mama ate the pygmy, the pygmy ate the monkey. The monkey has a gift that he is sending back to you. Look, here comes a missionary with his small. Geneva.
always make me sad. Miley Cyrus floats in a swimming pool in Toluca Lake, and you're the best girl I ever had. Can't remember anything at all.
You've been very patient with us, and very helpful. Thank you.
Yeah, well, that patience is starting to wear pretty thin.
Of course. Right outside.
Mr. Joyce.
Finally. Thought you wanted to talk, not get my life story.
Well, you were at the heart of all of this. And you can understand our need to find out exactly what happened.
I heard it's all being pinned on Paul. It's quite the feat.
Paul Serene always danced to his own tune, you know that. He and his delusions did tremendous damage to Monarch. But we can still salvage this company. We could use a man like you. It's not the same Monarch you know, Mr. Joyce. Your exceptional qualities are obvious, and we both know you have certain needs our expertise could help with. We can help each other.
Oh, really? Can I get a choice? No. Shame. Okay. That was a nice ending, but I really don't know why Hatch was there, because I assume he was killed. And my computer wanted to go into power saving mode there, so I got actually black screen because I didn't touch the mouse. But anyway, for real this time, see you on the next episode. Bye.